Cape Coral Canal was pulled out of the water today, and ABC7 was there to see it happen. We first told you about this yacht back in January when it was struck by lightning and caught fire. Then again last night when the burnt up boat was bumping into docks. It's your big story tonight. Thanks so much for staying up with us here on ABC7. I'm Megan Miller. Tonight, ABC7 Sarah Mankiewicz is getting you more on the next steps in this boat's journey.
Well, this is a huge boat. For reference, I'm about 5 feet tall, and this boat is about 60 feet long, which means getting it out of the water was no easy task.
Once in a blue moon do we get a boat that's caught fire and ends up being totaled, especially one this size.
Chase Fulton works at Owl Creek Boatworks and Storage in Alva. That's where the Sea Ray Cruiser yacht ended up, after going on quite a journey in southwest Cape Coral.
Looks like it got burnt to a crisp pretty well, and unfortunately it's past the point to where it can be fixed.
After being struck by lightning and catching fire back in January, the owner says he turned the boat over to his insurance company. This exclusive video shows it being towed by three people on a smaller fishing boat last Friday when it rammed into someone else's dock.
It was a frightening experience, to say the least. We heard the neighbors yelling, "Hey, John," who's my uncle, "somebody's about to hit your boat." And we got up, we ran down here, and sure enough, there was a boat floating backwards down the canal.
Saturday morning, boaters found the yacht named Nomos abandoned in the bay south of Tarpon Point Marina. After neighbors secured the boat, Cito and Fulton were called out to bring it to land.
A trailer this size to be able to get a boat like this on land and out of the water, you know, takes a lot of work. It took almost half the day just to set this boat on the trailer with our travel lift.
Since the boat is so big, it needed some trimming before leaving the boatyard.
You've got your radar and your antennas and everything on top. The transport company, they have to measure to see if it's going to clear the traffic lights, power lines.
Now Fulton tells me the yacht is off to a salvage yard in LaBelle. In Alva, Sarah Mankiewicz, ABC7.